When it comes to music, you couldn't get really much more Scottish than Sir Roderick of Stewart. And of course, that's great music in a form. It's pop music, but there's heritage music from Scotland being purveyed right across the Chesterfield this morning and up into the afternoon as well on this, the second day of the 50th Highland Gathering for Corby and right here in the heart of the UK. Our thanks to the University of Bedfordshire, who've just arrived and have been warming up because they have their own pipe band. Who knew that they did that? I'm not even sure that the University of Northamptonshire has got one of those, and that's going to be interesting as time goes on. Maybe they will have one. But if you were listening during the gardening phone-in a short while ago, you might have heard that for the very first time ever, the gardening phone-in was accompanied by Scottish music. Now, I've been joined by one of the members of the band that was providing, somewhat impromptu, that accompaniment. Good morning, sir. What is your name?
My name's Paul Wright. I'm the pipe major at Beverley and District Pipe Band.
That's not Scotland, is it, Beverley?
It's not. We're up in East Yorkshire.
So what is the attraction for you of getting a crowd of redoubtable... Is it all men, your band?
No, there's a mixture of men and men and women, boys and girls.
So all ages, then?
Indeed, yes.
What does it take to get all of you together to play pipe music? Because if you're not from Scotland, what's the attraction?
The attraction differs from one member to the next. We have a few Scots in the band, people like myself that got involved through the cadet force in Hull. So there's a real mix of reasons why people do it. But there's obviously the common theme of the pipes, that there's something in the music and the sound that brings us all together.
I'm glad you said that, because I was about to say to you, what is the attraction of the music?
For me, it's the challenge of trying to get the instrument in tune and multiply that across the number of pipers in the band. There's something about that challenge and getting a good sound. I can't put my finger on it. I don't think anyone can. There's something about the music.
Do you live this kind of music away from playing with the band? I mean, is it an accompaniment to your life?
It's a big part of my life, but it's all circled around the band. There's a few solo jobs throughout the year that keep me busy, but my main focus is the band and trying to develop the sound and improve the standard of playing within the band.
You said that you've got both sexes and a range of ages involved, so recruitment isn't perhaps a problem?
Unfortunately, it is. Certainly in the lower grades and in England particularly. Obviously in Scotland they have school programmes where children are encouraged and they have... The opportunities are presented to them within the schools to learn and get involved. It was something I would love to do down here in England, but trying to get people involved is very difficult. I used to work in a school. I started out teaching a bunch of youngsters. The first session I had 20-something youngsters, and then within the few weeks it depleted to just a handful.
So. You didn't have 20 sets of bagpipes going off in different directions at once?
No. You start off on a practice chanter. It's very easy to get started, much like a recorder if you have no experience of the pipes. You start with the technique of the playing of the melody, the finger technique, and after some months then you progress to the pipes and learn the art of blowing steady and producing hopefully a good sound and a good tone.
You and the band are from Beverley.
Yes.
What are you doing here? Being part of the Highland Gathering, is it competition? Is this a very important day for you?
It's one of the few competitions in England that are relatively local to us. Other than these types of events here at Corby and later in the year at Chatsworth House, and even further down south in Colchester, if you're that way based, then. We've got a competition. We've just literally been called by the steward to go on, so unfortunately I think we're going to have to draw this short. As much as I would like to talk to you and encourage as many people locally to get involved, it looks like we're having to move on.
That's perfectly all right. We were going to get you to play, but unfortunately the requirements... Can we perhaps get a very quick sound of something that the general audience would understand from the Beverley Pipe Band? Now, when you hear them start up, it'll sound like something's groaning, but that's just so that they can get to the point of playing. So, gentlemen, in your own time, something that we, who perhaps are not Scottish, will recognise.
One, two.
Thank you.
excellent. And if anybody doesn't recognise that, then you should be coming here to learn a little bit about the Corby Highland Games. So what's your name?
Martin Campbell.
Martin?
Morgan Graham.
That's a very Scottish name. Tell me, you've got Scottish heritage.
I was born in Scotland, Thurso, originally.
How long have you been playing the bagpipes for?
I started learning when I was 7 years old.
And just how athletic do you have to be? Is the power all from the diaphragm or is it from the lungs?
Most of it's from the diaphragm, I think. So.
Good beer drinking stuff as well in that guy. Excellent. Gentlemen, thank you very much indeed. I know you've got to go off and compete. I know you've got to go and play. Bless you for delaying yourselves a few moments. Good luck, as they say. So that's the Beverley Pipe Band. What a fantastic piece of music. What a fantastic bit of performance. Come along to the Charter Ground, to the Charter Field in Corby for this, the second day of the 50th Highland Gatherings. We will be talking to the gathering chieftain as soon as he arrives, because he's our mate. That's our own Martin Borley. We'll talk to him. We've got some great music to come through the course of the day, but if we played Rod Stewart and then we played that fantastic piece of pipe music, what else could we play that would have a sort of Scottish feel to it? This band performed, or at least in one of its guises, at the village of Wootton in Northampton some years ago. I know, because I introduced them on stage. They were brilliant. Let's go back to the days of the 70s. A bit of Shang-a-Lang. If ever there was a time to be wearing the tartan, it has got to be today. Good morning and welcome. This is BBC Radio Northampton with the mid-morning show coming to you live from the Charterfield here in Corby. As I look out across what is a flat part of the field, there are the numbers 5 and 0 painted on what would be grass, but now is something more like scrub. It's very, very dry. It's very, very warm. So if you're coming along, make sure that you're hydrated. Make sure that you've got suntan lotion with you, because you will see something that is very much of the heritage of Scotland, and may I say, very much of the heritage of the fair town of Corby. Now, we were talking to the Beverley Pipe Band. We thought we were going to get the whole band playing, but they had to go, and they had to go and compete. And that means that they had to be under the aegis of the gentleman that is in front of me this morning, a fine, upstanding gentleman name of Walter McGregor, and it says RSPBA. Now, that's nothing to do with the Royal Society for the Protection of Birds. Walter, good morning. What is the RSPBA?
The RSPBA is the Royal Scottish Pipe Band Association, based in Glasgow, and we have about 16 branches, and I'm the chairman of the London and South of England branch, and in that capacity work with Mark and his team and the Corby Highland Gathering Committee to run the championships today.
I'm assuming you were brought up with an accent like that on the pipes.
I have to say I was brought up in Glasgow, but I've been 39 years down in the south of England enriching the lives of the indigenous population.
Do you think you've won?
Of course.
Now, if ever there was anybody that can tell me about what it takes to become a great pipe band player, it's you, because you're the director of the competition that's going on here today. So what are the skills that are needed to become a pipe player?
Very, very first of all is to be a good musician, be able to read music and be able to play with your colleagues in the band and the pipers in unison. That's very important. Also with the drumming, you have to be a very skilled musician for playing all the drums in the drum corps. You've got a bass, tenor and obviously your back line of snares. And it's playing all together. And the ensemble sort of performance of the band is so important.
It really does stir the blood when you hear it. I'm not quite sure what it is that stirs the blood, and I come from Northampton. I'm Northampton born and bred, but I can feel something developing in me. If it's not an irreverent question, is it possible for bagpipes to play quietly?
No, the instrument's is a loud instrument, very loud instrument, and it's really for the outside. In a day like this, to have maybe 150 bagpipers and drummers playing in the mass bands, fantastic sound.
The Queen is a real fan of bagpipes. Every morning she has a piper wake her up wherever she is. That must be a very proud thing for the Scottish community.
Yes, of course it is. Of course it is. Wonderful, wonderful. Scottish music is wonderful. And it's revered all across the world. You get bands from Canada, America, New Zealand, Australia, Germany, Sweden, I think from Denmark, so all over.
Walter, your chest positively grew at that point. You're a very proud man with a pipe sound.
Oh, yes, definitely, definitely.
And what would you say is the quality of pipe playing that you've experienced so far this weekend?
The piping is very good. Some better than others, I have to say, but very good. Yes, it's good music. And if people should come along today and enjoy the competitions.
How important is it to get youngsters to start playing the bagpipes for the future of the skill, for the future of the music?
Well, you know, all bands suffer from the effects of Anno Domini. And if you don't have youngsters learning, you won't have a band in a few years' time. That's the real problem we have.
Is that the McGregor tartan you've got on?
Of course, yes.
It couldn't be anything else. Walter, an absolute pleasure to talk to you. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Walter McGregor, the director of the pipe competition, the pipe band competition that's going on here. We're heading for the news on BBC Radio Northampton. I can't believe how quickly time is going, but it'll be Annie Lennox that takes us to the news at 11 o'clock this morning. Walking on Broken Glass, great song. We'll continue the mid-morning show after the 11 o'clock news.